Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm super excited because we're taking the SkySurfer aircraft out for a ride to a local coffee shop. At the same time, I thought I'd answer some of the most popular questions I get asked, like how to fly, how to control it, some of its latest updates, and cool new features like AutoPilot. For anyone that's new here, the SkySurfer aircraft is the world's smallest and first electric drone vehicle that can fold down to fit into a box so small you can carry it with you onto a passenger plane and travel with it. Because of you guys, we're one step closer to a future where we can all say,
"Honey, I'm flying to the grocery store. Need anything?"
So huge shout out to you guys who are the ones making all of this possible by subscribing to this channel and following along for the journey here. After this video, if you're craving more details or maybe even want to pick one up for yourself, feel free to check out our website. Now, let's talk about what I personally think is the coolest new feature on the SkySurfer Pro model. It can fly to you on its own. All you need is a cell phone or a computer. When it shows up, just step on it, grab the controller, and off you go. It's like calling an Uber, minus the small talk and questionable air fresheners. This thing stays within 1 inch of where you tell it to fly, thanks to a whole new system packed with all kinds of industrial electronics and sensors. While flying by itself, the flight range is theoretically unlimited because it connects to hundreds of different redundant networks. Think cell phone towers, satellites, and encrypted radio signals. All that means is it's super safe. It's designed so that everything has a backup, so you're basically flying on 3 aircrafts instead of just one. Next up, let's talk about flight time and battery charging. Each SkySurfer aircraft comes with a charging system that works with 120 and 240 volts, so it doesn't matter what side of the world you live on. It takes around 45 minutes to charge the batteries, or you can easily swap them out with a new set if you just want to keep flying. During testing, we flew for around 30 minutes, but decided to stop there because the parts start to get pretty toasty. I like to say a solid 20 plus minutes of flight is a good estimation. A pretty cool thing is that every time you land, the batteries slightly recharge themselves, so you could theoretically fly for hours if you keep landing, taking off again. Without going in too deep, it's like the SkySurfer saying,
"Hey, slow down there, I need a little break too."
The chemistry inside the batteries has to work pretty hard when you're flying, so when you land, it settles down a bit, and that helps give you an extra boost of power to keep going. The amount of time you can fly depends on a whole lot of different things, but the most important one is your weight. The 30 plus minutes of flight that I got was with a 185-pound person, but we've designed the SkySurfer to carry up to 500 pounds. I've even flown with 2 people before. You might be wondering, what happens if I need to replace something like a broken propeller or motor? We have a parts store that everyone can easily access to order replacements. We had to design and engineer our own custom parts because nothing out there was made for human flight. The parts are designed to handle extreme heat, vibrations, and heavy weight, all with safety as a priority. So basically, it's like having a pit crew for your personal aircraft. All right. Let's give a quick nod to the FAA. They really appreciate it when I remind you to follow all rules and regulations while flying. All this footage is behind the scenes of a project we were hired for, so it took a good bit of work to set up. I think it's funny when you point out all the people and moving cars in this video are actually working for us. We even have people in disguise, so if you spot them, drop a comment. And hey, if you like this video, hit that like button to help it reach more people. You might notice some extreme shaking and bumps in this video. None of that is actually there. The camera is unfortunately mounted on a pole that's just swinging around. When you're flying, it's actually a smooth ride and feels just like standing on the ground. Now, I know you're curious about this ridiculous camera mount held on by military-grade duct tape, and to that I say, don't worry, it's classified. One thing I haven't talked about much is how you control the aircraft while you're flying. In my hand is a controller we built, complete with a small computer and programming to make it feel like you're, like I said, just standing on the ground, and whatever direction you look is essentially where you go. Kind of like a car, you've got gas and brake, and if you drop the controller, don't worry, the SkySurfer takes over. We've made sure there are multiple ways to control it, so you're always covered. The controller has a screen for things like battery power, speed, altitude, operating temperatures, alarms, and a whole lot more. It can connect to helmets and headphones, so it can talk to you and recommend landing if an alarm goes off. You can customize it however you want, for example, with new alarms, timers for how long you've been flying, and warnings if you go over a certain speed. The possibilities are endless. Now let's talk about the best part, which is power. I've flown at speeds of 65 miles per hour or 104 kilometers per hour for my metric friends, and stopped early because, well, that's pretty fast. We've designed the SkySurfer with more power than it needs, so if a motor stops, the others can easily keep you flying. It takes about 1 second to take off and a few more to reach 40 feet up. If you're not interested in flying to the moon, you can always limit the speed and power with a few button clicks inside the controller. The SkySurfer has endless features and capabilities that I've personally programmed into it. I'd love to create videos for each and really dive deep into them. Hitting subscribe will give us the opportunity to create more, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.